Welcome. In this video, we'll take a look at the non-normal procedure for a hydraulic pump overheat. We're descending on an RNAV arrival when the master caution light illuminates. The pilot flying states,
"My aircraft."
The HYD on the first officer's annunciator panel draws our attention to an issue on the hydraulic panel on the overhead panel. Looking up, we can see a light is illuminated on the hydraulic panel, which reads overheat, right above the electric motor-driven pump 2 switch. The 737 has two hydraulic systems, System A and B. Each system is comprised of an engine-driven pump and an electric motor-driven pump, known as EDMP. As stated, in this case, the electric hydraulic pump number 2 has overheated. This is caused when the hydraulic pump drain fluid or pump itself has overheated. Now that the problem has been identified, the pilot flying calls for the checklist.
Hydraulic pump overheat checklist.
After looking for the checklist on the quick reference card, where applicable, the pilot monitoring then looks in the quick reference handbook, known as QRH. The index doesn't have any entries listed under H, where you might look for a hydraulic issue, so where is the checklist? There are two ways to find it. Search for the illuminated word, in this case, overheat. And there is the link to the checklist, under O. Another way to find the checklist is to look in the hydraulic section itself within the QRH in its own index. On finding the checklist, the pilot monitoring then reads the checklist title and condition out loud, seeking the pilot flying's input if it is the correct checklist before performing it. Notice, in the top left of the checklist is an illustration of the light, giving us visual input as to what this checklist is for.
Hydraulic pump overheat checklist. Condition, the hydraulic pump temperature is high. Do you agree?
I agree.
Both pilots agree this is the correct checklist, so the pilot monitoring moves to step 1.
Electric hydraulic pump switch on the affected side to off. It's off. Note, one pump supplies sufficient pressure for normal system operation.
The four black boxes indicate the checklist has been completed. The pilot monitoring therefore states,
hydraulic pump overheat checklist complete.
When the pump was switched off, the low pressure light illuminated. This would be considered associated as it was a result of the pump being switched off. Let's practice an overheat of electric hydraulic pump number 1 from the first officer's perspective.
My aircraft. Hydraulic pump overheat checklist.
Hydraulic pump overheat checklist. Condition, the hydraulic pump temperature is high. Do you agree?
I agree.
Electric hydraulic pump switch on the affected side to off. It's off. Note, one pump supplies sufficient pressure for normal system operation. Hydraulic pump overheat checklist complete.
We hope you enjoyed our look at the short procedure for when a hydraulic pump overheats. Please subscribe, click like if you enjoyed, and join us next time when we learn more about the 737. Thank you.